switcheroo. Wearing the pink shirt again. Actually, it's the same day with many videos. If you've been watching a bunch of videos. We're going to model, do some more modeling with functions. You might notice that there's a part one and part two, because word problems are tough. So I'm trying to show you as many examples as I can to help you with whatever class you guys are in. So these modeling questions are in my pre-calc book. Give you a teaser or start to help you set up learning how to do your related rate problems in calculus. We're not doing related rates, but they're similar in setup with a lot of these questions. So, you know, just there's a purpose of all this. So what I would like to talk about now is volume versus surface area. And we're going to do that to a cube. So I'm going to draw a cube here, without taking up too much of my precious time. Precious because I want to do more of these videos today. And that corner should be up there more, but good enough. Okay, so we have a cube. And I want to discuss or relate the area of this surface area of this cube to its volume. So I want the volume of this cube to be set at 900 cubic units, and have the dimensions of x, and have the y value, or the height fixed at y. So the base is square, and the height is adjustable, or a different variable, excuse me. So I want to talk about the surface area of this sphere, and ultimately I just want it in terms of x. So that's the question. Write me a surface area formula in terms of x. Well, let's try and just talk about surface area. If you remember it, there is a formula for the surface area of a cube, but if you don't, let's just figure it out. Surface area, and this is, I started to draw this open, but I'm going to have it closed. There is a top to this. Surface area is equal to what? Well, there's a top and bottom. The bottom and top is x times x for the area of the rectangle on the top and the bottom of the box. So it's 2x squared for this particular cube, length times width for the rectangular bottom. Now, the square box has four sides to it, and each side is going to have a width of x all along the four sides and a height of y. So let's take this side here because the y is right here. The area of that rectangle is x times y, and there's four of those rectangles going around the outside of the cube. So it's 4xy. Good. So this is surface area for any box, any rectangular solid that has a square base. Well, yay. But this is not in terms of x. I got a y. So now what? Well, I'm going to relate the surface area of this box to the volume, which is 900. How do you find the volume of a cube or a box? It's length, width, and height. So for this particular example, it'd be x squared times y. Well, I don't want the volume to be just anything. I want the volume to be 900 cubic units. All right. Good. So for this rectangular solid, box, whatever cube, whatever you want to call it, it's not a cube, by the way, all three sides have to be the same if it was a cube. So for this rectangular solid, we have a fixed volume that we must meet, but the surface area, the shape of the box is fluid. I just want to make sure it holds 900 cubic units. I can use that fixed volume formula to help me get rid of y in my surface area formula. If I want to get rid of y, I want this equation solved for y, which will just have x's on the other side. So this is going to be y is equal to 900 divided by x squared. Aha! So I don't want the surface area of any normal rectangular solid with a square base. I want that rectangular solid to have a volume of 900. That allows me to take out y and in its place plug in 900 over x squared, and that's going in for y. So the surface area in terms of x is equal to 2x squared plus 4x times 900 over x squared. Oh, we're almost done. 2x squared plus 3,600. Not 3,000. 3,600 over, this is x on top, and this is x squared on the bottom. Some of those will cancel out, leaving me with just an x on the bottom. And that is surface area in terms of x. Bam! All right. That was a quiet bam. It was kind of a hard question, though, wasn't it? Bam! There we go. Celebrate some more. Surface area of a cube whose volume has got to be 900 in terms of x. Okay. Next and last example for this modeling with functions lesson, which is now three videos, we're going to talk about a cone. This might not even be in your pre-calc book. If it is, it might just be one near the end. This is really a common or a nice, a more familiar setup in calculus, but you might see it just in there to kind of tease what you might, you know, what you're going to see next year. So I've got a cone. I'm going to fill it with water. So in here is going to be some blue water. I'm shaking the cone around. And this cone has a radius of 5 and a depth of 15 units. And then somewhere in there is going to be a certain level of water. In calculus, that water will be filling. And you'll be talking about how quickly the radius or the volume is changing in certain areas, and we're not in calculus though. So we're just going to talk about, I want to write the volume of the water. So let me use blue to match the water. So write a formula for the volume of water in this cone that is only in terms of the height or the depth, or excuse me, what am I doing? Let's write in terms of the radius. So I can measure how wide the water is on top and then come up with the volume. Well, the volume of a cone is 1/3 pi r squared times h. Yeah, okay, spacing out a little bit, sorry. So, okay, I want to write this formula. So for volume, so that all, and again, it's going to be specific to this shape of cone, so that it's in terms of R and not R and H. Okay. How am I going to do that? Well, unlike all the other problems I've given you where I said what the area was and I talked about perimeter, or like the last one where I said the volume has to be this and then I talked about surface area, I'm not giving you a design where I'm giving you two pieces of information that have formulas attached to them. So somehow I have to work out of this diagram how I could get the H out and replace it with something that just has R in it. Well, let's see. Cones have, they're straight on the side, yes? So straight line leaning over to the right. Isn't that kind of like slope? If I go from here up to the top and over, I'm looking at a slope of the side of this side of the side of this cone. I'm looking at a slope of 3 up 15 and over 5. Well, 15 over 5 reduces down to 3 over 1. So if I go from the bottom up to the water level, well, I don't know how tall that is, but I've got some R value here. And we're going to have this h value, and how does h relate to r? H is going to be equal to 3 times the radius. So whatever, I go up 15 and over 5, so my slope is rise over run, that means my height is going to be 3 times whatever my radius is. Oh. So h equals 3r. So I can take out h and put in 3r in its place, and my formula becomes 1/3 pi, oh actually no, 1/3 times 3 is 1, excuse me. So pi r cubed. So for a cone, specific cone, where the depth is 3 times the radius, my volume of my cone in terms of r is just pi r cubed. Pretty cool. Now, for this cone, let's say I wanted to measure the volume of water just by the depth. Like maybe I'm going to stick a, you know, put a stick down to the bottom and measure how much the stick is wet. So maybe I want to measure the volume in terms of the depth of the water or the height of the water. So let me do a different color so that you don't realize that I'm getting a little scatterbrained here. End of the day, I want the volume in terms of H now. How can I do that? Well, same cone, depth is still 3 times the radius. Well, if I want to take out the radius and talk about the volume in terms of just H instead of R, I can take my relationship between the height and the radius I just noticed. I can solve it for R, because now I want the R out, and I want just H's in there. So that's going to be H over 3 equals R. Oh! So I can take out the R, replace it with H over 3, and remember that it's squared, and get 1/3 pi H squared over 9 H, and get 1 over 27 pi, and then H squared times H is H cubed, and that's volume in terms of H. Bam! All right, thank you very much.